Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. It's Wednesday, midweek, July the 13th, 2011. I'm D. Martez, your brother, cousin, uncle, best friend, co-worker, castmate, neighbor, everything wrapped up into one, and I'm back. Yeah, been on a little break, but I am back now. Thanks so much for coming to DMartez.com to hear today's show. I'm your source for information, inspiration, and laughter. Today, midweek Wednesday, is going to be the best day of your life. Something good is definitely going to happen to you. So, you're on the new website. What do you think? Like it? You see how the blogs are and, you know, everything's different, upgrading here on the D. Martez Show to make things better for you. Want to point out one specific tab that is just for you, the listeners, and it's the listeners tab. So if you click on that tab, I tell you, you know, what the listeners tab is about. But in case you didn't read it, this tab is specifically for you, the listener. So if you're an artist, if you cook and you have a great recipe, if you, you know, if there's an event going on at your church, if there's something going on here in town, you can send me an email, okay, with that information. I'll post that information right here on the listeners tab. So it's your spot as the listener. If you notice, there's a poll right here on the site, and the poll is about Casey Anthony. You know, we all know about Casey Anthony and that whole ordeal, so I'm not going to get into that. But be sure to answer that poll and also the poll question about Michelle Obama. And you probably see that, and I'll get to that in just a moment. So I'm back and I'm happy. Glad to be back. Definitely. Hands down. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay. Famous people born on today, July the 13th, 100 BC. Yeah, 100 BC before Christ. Julius Caesar. Today is Caesar's birthday. In 1986, Mary Kate and Ashley Olsen, they were born, the Olsen twins. They turn 26 today. And I know you remember the Olsen twins from Full House. Remember the Full House theme song? Whatever happened to you? Now see, I never knew this part right here. And who's singing that? It's everybody part right here. Everywhere you look, everywhere. Yeah, Full House, that used to go so hard. Okay, also, Raz B, he turns 27 today. You know, Raz B is from the group B2K. Now, tomorrow, Thursday, July the 14th, Boy George, his birthday is tomorrow. Donald Trump and Marla Gibbs, they celebrate their birthdays. Boy George turns 51, Donald Trump 66, and Marla Gibbs 81. Wow, and I know you remember Marla Gibbs from 227, Mary from 227. Great theme song, 227. Yeah. No place like home. With your family around you, you're never alone. When you know that you love that, 227. Also on this day in history in 1923, the Hollywood sign was dedicated. Back in 1923. Also in 1977 on this day, a power cut blacks out New York City. And there was like huge widespread looting and vandalism that occurred to this. The big blackout in 1977. I wasn't even born yet. Okay, so what's going on here in the city? Well, if you're in the mood for a good play, what about going to New Venture Theater to see Crowns? Now, if you remember, I told you about this wonderful play that premiered earlier this year. Well, they're bringing Crowns back July 23rd and 24th at 2 p.m. and 7:30 p.m. Tickets $20. You can visit newventuretheater.com for more information. And I'm telling you, this is a great play. It's about the meaning of the church hats. The ladies wearing the hats in church, and I don't want to tell the story, but it's really good. Lots of singing, great acting, great hats. I'm telling you, bring your mom, bring your grandmother. You're gonna like it. Check out Crowns, and I'm gonna have the cast of Crowns right here on the D. Martez show. So, fitness, you want to get fit? Well, what about fun and fitness boot camp? Yes, visit www.funfitnessbootcamp.com, and that's fun with two N's, or you can call 225-302-8976 for more information. These fun and fitness boot camps start July the 18th and they run until August the 11th. It's a 4-week session just for ladies. Registration is $25. It includes a t-shirt, water bottle, carrying bag, and a comprehensive nutritional guide. So again, 225-302-8976 for more information. Here we go on today's show. Okay, so we have a prison preacher who paid an inmate for oral sex. Yeah. Michelle Obama is under fire for eating a burger and fries. And also, a woman tries to sneak her husband out of jail in a suitcase. All of that, and of course, music here on The D. Martez Show. Let's kick it off with the number one song in the country. Yeah, number one song. It's LMFAO, and that song is Pretty Rock Anthem featuring Lauren Burnett and Goon Rock. Pretty Rock Anthem. You could jam to this, I guess.
Shake that.
Now you have to admit that song will go very hard on the treadmill. Like, seriously, it would. Like, I'm on a treadmill just like, oh, get it, party rock it going hard tonight, everybody. Okay, all right, so Michelle Obama under fire for eating burger and fries. Yeah, First Lady Michelle Obama has been criticized for ordering a highly caloric meal at a combined count of 1,700 calories. Okay, she went to the new Shake and Shack in Washington, D.C., and she had a burger, fries, chocolate shake, and a Diet Coke. Now, you know that Michelle Obama is the spearhead of the Let's Move campaign, which is geared towards ending child obesity and, of course, raising exercise awareness. So basically, they're worrying about what's going into Michelle's mouth. So is this criticism warranted? To what degree should the Obamas be perfect role models of a healthy diet? You know, I mean, Michelle Obama in appearance is a fit lady. She has a wonderful body, you know, and no matter how fit you are, everyone needs a cheat day. Hello? I mean, do you expect people to eat vegetables and grilled chicken every single day of their life? I mean, you gotta have a cheat day. So what, 1,700 calories? I'm sure Michelle burned that off because she said she gets up at like 4:30 in the morning and works off. So Michelle, you know, I have a song for you, you know, that you should just play to all these haters out there. You know, Michelle, this is what I say. This is what you should do. Yeah.
some more chicken, have some more pie. It doesn't matter, it's boiled or fried. Just eat it.
Eat it.
Just eat it.
Eat it.
Just eat it.
Eat it. Eat it. Eat it, Michelle. Eat the cake, anime. You know, that was Will Weird Al Yankovic and Eat It. Yeah, just let her eat it. It's really not that serious. Okay, prison preacher paid inmate for oral sex. Now, this story is, this is something here. And I'll fill you in on this one. Okay, so this happened in New York, okay? Frank DeTucky, a 70-year-old prison chaplain at the Queensborough Correctional Facility, has admitted to paying an inmate to let him perform oral sex on him. Now, this is reported by the New York Daily News. When questioned, DeTucky admitted that on July 5th, he paid the same inmate $120 and $150 on two separate occasions to perform oral sex on him in the chaplain's office at the minimum security Long Island City facility. DeTucky has been a chaplain for the state correctional system for 27 years and is a deacon at Our Lady of Mount Carmel Church in Astoria. Wow, so, you know, this man is $120 and $150. Why did the price go up? What happened? You know, I'm not going to even go there. More music for you. What about Beyonce? Yeah, lover or hater, but guess what? Beyonce is doing her thing. She has the number one album in the country right now, and her single, yeah, The Best Thing I Never Had. It's blowing up the radio charts. Here's Beyonce, Best Thing I Never Had, here on The DeMartez Show. Beyonce, Best Thing I Never Had. And when you kind of listen to the words of that song, it's really kind of deep there, you know. But a lot of people say Beyonce's latest album is whack. I don't have it. I was thinking about getting it, but, you know, should I? Should I not? You know, we'll see what the next single is going to be. Okay, so woman tries to sneak husband out of jail in a suitcase. Very interesting story here. Okay, so police say a woman, and this happened in Mexico, by the way, was caught trying to sneak her common law husband out of a Mexican prison in a suitcase following a visit. A spokesman for the police staff says that the prison staff noticed the woman seemed nervous and was pulling a black wheeled suitcase that looked bulky. Well, I guess so. A person was in it. Spokesman Geraldo Campos said Monday that prison guards checked the bag of 19-year-old Maria Del Mar and found inmate Juan Ramirez curled up inside in a fetal position. Ramirez is serving a 20-year sentence for a 2007 conviction for illegal weapon possession. Okay? And Delmar, well, she was arrested and her charges are pending. You know, what will you do in the name of love? You just never... You know, I wonder, does she feel like played? Does she feel bad? What was she saying? Was she pulling at and like, oh, this suitcase is so heavy. And you know, what were the, you know, guards thinking? Like, what does this woman have in this suitcase? It looks like things look heavy. Pulling a person. Okay. Well, that's it for today. I'm D. Martez, again, your source for information, inspiration, and laughter. Remember to always visit dmartez.com to get your dose of that information. Spread the word. You can follow me on Twitter at D_Martez or like my Facebook page. Yeah, search for me, D. Martez. Like the page. I'll keep you in the loop. I promise, I promise, I promise. All right, so as I leave you, what am I listening to? What's in my CD player right now? Yeah, it's a throwback. This is Gerald Scott and Company, and this is Don't Let Go. Let this song minister to you. I'll holler at you on Friday, and Friday's on the D. Martez Show. It's all about health and fitness and sex. D. Martez signing out. Remember, I love you listening.
Listen up, my brother and my sister. I'm talking to you. Got some things I need to say, and I don't want to miss you. I'm talking to you. You've been feeling really hopeless. Life's like a mess. If I'm talking to you, there's a remedy for you that I'm going to suggest. I'm talking to you.
That's what you should do.
Don't do it.